Okay, I'm back with more Gotland, and today we're going to be doing a big war. The plan is to attack Russia. I wanted to attack the Commonwealth, but Persia's not going to join, Ming's not going to join. Allied these two and got rid of Tunis. It's too far away, Spain has a truce, Bohemia has a truce. Ottomans alone will not be enough. So, I've come up with an alternative plan. We will be attacking Georgia, who is guaranteed by Russia. That means I don't have to fight my allies, Spain and Persia. Now, Spain will not join. Bohemia will join if I tell him to prepare for war. The Ottomans will join if I promise them land. And everyone else, well, I won't have favors with Ming, so whatever. Persia actually would join if they were not in debt. So, I like the idea of getting Persia to fight Russia. I canceled my vassalization of Cyprus and Wales. I just annexed Wales after the truce ran out. It's basically, you guys get over there. So I'm going to be killing the Russian Navy. I don't actually have the admin to core these provinces, but I took Tech 26 like 6 years ahead of time because it's a morale tech, and I want to press that advantage while I have it. So we can call in Persia. We can promise you land, right? First, Bohemia. Prepare for war. That will give you plus 20 reasons to join an offensive war, which is enough. This should be a fairly one-sided war, but basically I want to deal a nice big blow to the Russians so that I can get rid of their alliances. And it's not going to be easy, because they gained 7,500 manpower per month. 7,500 manpower. That's just insane. I have the second biggest army in the world. Russia is the biggest. I don't know what the hell happened to Ming, but they just have had no manpower for a very long time. Probably AI suffering tons of attrition, because that's what AI does. It's going to be me and Ottomans. Plus, who else? Bohemia is down here. Russia's down here, so we're looking at, like, what? This is, let's say, this is about 200. So Persia's over here. This is about 140, 240k. Me and Ottomans are going to be contributing about 660. So we're going to be having, like, almost a million troops. So this should be a fairly one-sided war, but basically I want to annul his alliance with Spain, and then want to keep the truce fairly short, and then I'm going to come back with Ming once the truce is over and attack him directly. And just, like, really weaken him. I don't know, I might take these provinces. These are the two provinces I need for my achievement. Besides the Commonwealth land. So I look at Commonwealth here. They have a truce with Spain till 1730. And truce with Bohemia until 1730. Me and Ottomans alone, again, as I said, not enough to take on the Commonwealth-France alliance. France? I did piss off France a little bit. So he could potentially coalition me, but most of these guys I either have a truce with or they can't join. Like Friesland, he likes me. He can't join. Utrecht likes me, he can't join. Oldenburg, we have a truce with. Because what I did off camera was, I attacked Hamburg, because Wurzburg was at war, he was being sieged up, he wouldn't join. So I attacked Hamburg, I took Hamburg, and what am I trying to say? Like, I cyber-pieced all of his allies for money and stuff. Tuscany, we're just never going to be friends. So anyway, enough blabbering. Let's do it. on all these guys. And honestly, the Ottomans, they can have whatever Georgian land they want. So, what are we looking at here? The Russians have some pirates. They will fall quickly. But the numbers look like pretty heavily in our favor. Which is just the way I like it. I also invested in some new forts. Do I have a leader back here somewhere? Yes, you have the siege guy. You're into Pskov. You're into Ingerman land. I could go to Novgorod, but I don't think I will. I invested in some forts. Specifically, this fort. It won't block the Russians from entering my land, but it'll keep them distracted because they'll try and siege it down. I've got one in Åland to prevent them from just crossing, going across here, sieging up all this land. This also applies to when I'm fighting wars in Europe. They can't. Well, the issue I was having before was like they'd siege up this area, the Baltic and Finland, and then they just go like, "Oh, hey, I'm going to go siege up your core land." It's like, no, I need that to take loans. Come on now. I may or may not keep the fort in Shelland. It is a nice choke point, but so far I don't think it's been that needed that much because I have naval superiority here easily. So I think I will actually ditch the fort in Shelland. What will I replace it with? That's a good question. Well, I already got a shipyard. I already got a conscription center. So, maybe a training field? I don't know. I don't think a town hall is really going to do much. Well, for now, we'll build a stock exchange. Get some extra trade power in this province. This is what, plus 20 local trade power? It's good stuff. So anyway, I don't think the fort in Shelland is needed anymore. Fort over here in Schleswig, it's a nice choke point to cut off anyone who wants to come into my land over here. And I don't know, I don't think I need any forts in this area. I might put one on, say, like Trondelag or something, to keep them busy if they come around like all the way over this way. Maybe that's not a bad idea. I could take lots of loans. I don't know why, but for some reason the amount of loans I can take fluctuates sometimes. I like that idea. Let's build a... No, I can't do it here, because there's already a conscription center. Let's build a fortress over here in Trondelag. I invested in more of an army, specifically more cannons, got rid of some of my mercenaries. Haven't had a ton of time for my manpower to recover, and it's especially not helped by the fact that I've got those stupid freaking spy actions against me constantly. Literally, you just have like these permanent malices against you for existing past 1700. Like, minus 3 diplomatic reputation is insanely powerful. It's just completely broken is what it is. So there's going to be a coalition. And France will join it, probably. What? Why are you making me lose legitimacy? Fine. Big thing is that I'm pretty sure I have enough diplomatic reputation. Yeah, as long as it's positive, then my allies should honor my alliances. So you here can go like over here or so. And I'm losing a lot of money per month because these forts cost a lot of money to maintain. Look at that. Oh, you know what? I still have a fort in London that's costing me money. London is a crazy good province. heard I got a stock exchange too. It's got like really high autonomy though, because it's not in a state. I'll have to go back and full core some of this stuff later, but for right now, that's not of a concern to me. I've got very good control over the Lubic node. Nobody else even really comes close. There are still some good provinces left in the Lubic node, like Bremen owned by Brunswick, East Frisia owned by East Friesland. Here are the Hamburg separatists, which I think Bohemia might go take care of. Haha! Thank you, Bohemia. So, just curious, do we have access through the Commonwealth? Yes, they give access to the Ottomans. Now, the war goal is in Georgia, but I'm focusing on Russia. I was keeping these guys over here to deal with rebels, but I don't know, maybe that's not necessary. I guess I can go send, like, a stack south to help out with whatever the Ottomans are doing. And yeah, this is very hard, so even Georgia can field, like, freaking 40k troops. Yeah. You know what? Sure. I'll go, like, send you south, maybe go attach you to an Ottoman stack. Is there anywhere you could go where you won't be suffering tons of attrition? Not really. Let's see, we've got one siege on this fort, one siege, you can go into St. Petersburg. Renewing more loans. And yeah, France entered the coalition. Commonwealth cannot. But, like, even if France declares, I mean, he's allied to the Commonwealth anyway. I hope the coalition doesn't declare, but it's possible that it might. So perhaps it wasn't a great idea to be... Well, I mean, most of these people are fairly tiny, like Magdeburg, Wurzburg. These are all, like, very tiny people. Is there anyone I might be able to get out of the coalition? Probably not. Wurzburg's just always gonna hate me because I removed provinces from the Empire. You know what? Who cares what Wurzburg thinks? I did get truces with a lot of these guys. See, there's a Russian stack down here. Let's grab that leader, and let's go use him in combat. Help liberate the Ottomans! I'm losing a lot of money per month, because everything is super expensive, because I have tons of inflation. But I can also take a lot of loans. So I'm not too concerned. Some advisor has died. I'd actually prefer I could get a better relations over time guy. So let's see how the Russians fight. Got only 105 to sustain. Just like me. For once, my troops are not garbage at fighting. I like it. Yeah, Persian Ottomans, they're gonna help me from the flanks. Got at least 20 cannons in each stack, which is enough for a full bonus on a level 6 fort. Also, still no better relations over time, guy. These fighters are so expensive to fire, it's ridiculous. Okay. Do that, I can demand diplomatic support. and you can be demanding military support from. Good. I have 4 years to be able to demand adequate support. I'm working my way through quality ideas right now, so that my troops are not like total garbage. The discipline at the end is nice. So, we've got St. Petersburg down. I guess let's head over to Novgorod. That also means his navy is going to come out and fight me. I've got tons of ships. I'm not very concerned. Ships are super cheap for me to build. Actually, you guys should go back and... Well, no. Guess we'll do. What is it? A? Yeah, repair damaged ships. These are all the ships that are damaged. Okay. Actually, how about we throw the whole fleet back and forth? Because there are ships that can be up there. Those are the galleys. And okay, we did get an improved relations guy. Fishianagar, he's just so annoying. Freaking Fishianagar. Let's see, I can. Can start coring some of these again soon. Do I want to send you over there? No, I think I want to keep my troops close together. Looks like the Ottomans are doing alright over here. The Commonwealth is the papal controller. Let's just say, like, what if I wanted to make peace? Could I take these two provinces? I can indeed do that without pissing off the Commonwealth. And I can do that while keeping the truce small enough that I can still attack them within 10 years. Because an old treaty lasts for 10 years. And you have to stay under 50 war score if you want the truce to last 10 years. Well, less than 10 years. Wow, Russia's going to siege now Bohemia, huh? Well, they're still on Tech 25, so I think I can win this battle. Let's go grab... I don't know, our king. Keep converting things. I'm aware that I'm losing tons of money per month, and I'm not really concerned about that. I may raise 4 taxes. I don't know. Let's go help out Bohemia. Praha's farmlands. He is going to outflank us, but we've got our morale bonus, so I think we'll be okay. I have confidence in my troops. Yeah, he doesn't even have defenses, so his morale is just bad. Easy. That's the thing, the Russians, like me, they don't have any good military bonuses in their ideas. Rather, they don't have anything that makes their troops fight better. Yeah, the armor tradition does kind of help a little, but most of it is based around quantity rather than quality. So, I guess you guys can just stick around. Oh, hello there. Retreated over here, huh? Smells like a wipe to me. Unless they're gonna go retreat back to their land now. Or maybe they're gonna retreat to the Georgian occupation? Potentially. Okay, they're gonna go retreat all the way back to their land now. That's fine. So what are these guys doing? They're doing good. This is gonna really eat into my manpower, which is unfortunate. But oh well. I have to stick together in these big stacks so that I don't get caught off guard. Let's see, I can core these provinces. Still have that mission? Okay, good, I can't put it. Are there any other policies that I want right now? No, I think that's pretty much it. That would be nice, economic and quality. Quality has very nice policies. So that's where you guys ran. Let's head over to Yaroslav. Smolensk is done, or actually, we don't need to wait for Smolensk. We can just head over right over to Ryazan. This is risky, but I'm gonna split up. Focused on military so I can get through quantity ideas. Sorry, not quantity, quality. This deck I'll just have run around this area and protect anything necessary. Revolutionary regiments. It's not 1750, so I cannot get revolutionary rebels yet. Sorry, I can't become a revolutionary government type. That would be very nice, but it can't happen. So what modifiers do I have on here? I've already got like minus 40%. So if I wanted to piss off the nobles even more, I could do that, but I don't think I will. I think after 1750, you can become revolutionary. That gives you some really nice bonuses. Makes your troops super cheap to maintain, as I recall. Let's see. Why do you have so many cannons? What is the purpose of this? I don't think we need to be influencing. English separatists. You know, I should have thought of that. Okay, change of plans. Get over to Riga. Bringing you over to England. It's gonna be a big revolt. So, once Smolensk is done, we will head off. Actually, never mind. I already have a snack left over there. So I don't know exactly how much Georgian land all of the Ottomans want, but whatever they want, they can have it. Alright, Smolensk is done. Let's keep pushing. Keep pushing. Alright, you guys. Let's detach about half the transports. And send them over. This other fleet, we can go back to blockading this area. So, once this war is done, I'm just going to need Commonwealth provinces in order to get my achievement suite and it's not overpowered. I will play this game all the way to 1821. In case there was any doubt about that. But that's the main the goal I have with this run, is to get Sweden is not overpowered. I need St. Petersburg, Ingram Inland, and then just some Commonwealth provinces. Let's see, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Seems like a couple of these are not required, actually. But I'll take them anyway. Maybe it's like these that aren't counted? I'm not sure. I'm not sure exactly which ones it counts as coast. I'll look at that in a moment. Maybe it's these ones that don't count as the coast. No, they got shipyards, so I don't know. Was this siege over here? The Russians are doing something. Let's go siege up the war goal. These guys to rise up, and they did. Good. So, you need to head in there with, this guy. Wherever he was, hopefully he wasn't important. You head back over there. And let's say, like, one of you. It's gonna be a costly battle, but must be done. Your onslaught was done. Oh, that was this guy. That leader didn't have siege, did he? No. Good. So, he's not really that necessary over here. Got the Russians nice and trapped over here. That's good. I see those Russians over there. When can they be there? October? Good. Okay, right, my king did get an heir, I remember now. You know, if I just waited a couple of years, I could have prevented France from joining the coalition, but I didn't want to wait a couple of years. Yeah, reduce overextension, that'll be done eventually. And when it is done, it'll be good. Okay. I could have ordered head over to Nizhny Novgorod, but I don't think I will. I don't want to suffer too much manpower losses, so I'll just stick to sieging up these non-fort provinces. Let my allies do the rest of the work. Less taxes at the cost of papal influence. Yeah. More money at the cost of less taxes. Well, I don't want less taxes. Taxes are important. I make like half my money from taxes. If I decline, I get one stability, but I'm going to lose 20 papal influence. When does that modifier expire? Because I need to have 50 papal influence for that. Okay, I've got lots of time. So, let's go for yearly legitimacy, spend some of that papal influence. Oh no, I lost 6 papal influence, how terrible. Where is... over here, yes. There's a lot of those Russians, this might not have been such a great idea. Okay, we won. We're just that good. But they're retreating over there. And plus they ran away, so it wasn't like they ran out of morale. So, yeah, no. That already cost me a lot of my infantry, and I don't have the manpower to reinforce that. Let's just get out of here. So let's go somewhere like, say, Moskva, where we won't be suffering attrition. I'm paying a lot of money for forts. Wait, you know what? Here we go, grab a mercenary right here. I just want to occupy Ingram and land and make it cheaper. When is that mercenary going to be done? Now, good. So, what I'm going to do is I'm going to not pay for these forts by making other people pay for them. So, like, this could go to Persia. Because I'm not taking any of this land, so. Anything that has a fort on it, Persia can pay for it. They're not going to want that land, but they're also not going to transfer it back to me. This is occupied by the Ottomans. This is occupied by me. Let's make it occupied by the Ottomans. That's in the Ottomans. It's occupied by Ottomans. And boom! All these provinces have been strategically occupied by Persia, who is now paying for all of these forts, not me. Now I'm only paying like half of what I was in fort maintenance. I'm still paying a ton. Corelia and that one. Aha. I missed one. What was that other one? Down here. These are getting occupied by Persia so he can pay for them. Not me. I only want to pay for my forts. Kazan, where is Kazan? Kazan is right here. Occupied by Persia. If Persia has to go into debt, then that's good for Persia. Oh yeah, so England is probably going to coalition me. But who cares what England thinks? Because England's all the way down here now. They've been kicked out of Great Britain. The Russian fleet is getting sunk. Very good. Very good. 7 heavy ships killed. We even gained a couple of transports, which is nice. How are we doing on force limit these days? We've got lots of force limit available. So I would say get maybe some more light ships. How much more force limit do we have available? About 60. So I would say maybe like 10 more galleys and 50 light ships. And let's take a loan so we can build that template. That's going to take me a bit over the force limit, but that's okay. How are we doing on loans? Yeah, I can have 229 loans. And this is the real strength of Gotland. I'm only paying 100 ducats in interest, even though I've got, what, 500,000 ducats in debt. Oh, nice. 100 admin from an event. I like it. So these cores will be done in July of 28, which is next year. So in about a year and a half or so. Our truce with Lübeck has ended, which means that he could coalition me now. And he probably will. We can seek the support of the clergy. Okay, good amount of legitimacy. And yeah, Lübeck's coalition. Okay. I threatened war over Stralsund. I didn't want to have to fight him again. So, I mean, our burghers could hate us more. Lübeck's Trade League is embargoing us. That's not nice. Reformed Zealots in Leinster. Okay. You could be there by like the 11th. You could be there by the 6th. You can grab this guy. How quick can you be there? The 26th. Perfect. Who else wants to rise up? Noble rebels? Oh, we'll deal with them if they spawn. I mean, Bohemia is being sieged up, but our alliance war score is very high. So let's see, we're at 3,800 loan size right now. And we've got mostly 3,400, 3,500 loans. That's probably fine. You do want to refinance your loans every so often, because the way the game works is that when it checks if you're going to go bankrupt, it only checks how many loans you have, not how much those loans are actually worth. And so you can go bankrupt while paying, like, a lot less than your allowed interest and income. A lot less than your income and interest. This should be a fairly easy battle, I think. Oh, damn, Russia got tech 26. He's gonna reinforce this now. The troops are still pretty good. We're still doing alright. See if our guys can hold out. Come on, come save the day, Hasa. Yes, I believe in you, Hasa. That was such a costly battle, but whatever. Ottomans are occupying a lot of Russian land, which indicates that he wants a lot of Russian land. I mean, if I keep this war going for a while, then I could probably get weak blood for this. In this war. And you know what? I like that idea. Diplotech? Sure. I get to some good heavy ships, but I don't care about heavy ships. To give us the final level of light ships, which will cost money. But oh well. I've got all of my light ships protecting over here in Lübeck. And I'm transferring trade from like a bunch of places so I can get some good bonuses. Yes, good Bohemia. Fight the Russian scum. Ha, he even managed to wipe him. Oh my god, that is some advanced strategy right there, Bohemia. That's awesome. They arrived on the same day that they lost the battle, so they were forced to retreat. That's funny. They only retreated one province away, but still. I'm suffering attrition. Where am I suffering attrition? Right, on this stack. Surprisingly, they have not tried to attack. The Pope is the Pope. Good for him. Nope, keep extending those loans. So Hamburg is now a full core, which means I should be getting some good trade power out of it. We could be seeing another coalition war coming soon, but my allies are stronger now. We should look at our diplomat mode. I'm allied to Ming. Ming and Persia. I don't know how much use Ming will be, since they'd have to go all the way over here, but they make me look strong. Persia will be useful. Persia's good. Oh, nice. I did get that fort done in Trondelag. Good, 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 good. So now might be a good time to go recruit some mercenaries. Finally, I could just send you guys back. It'll take a while, but... who said I had to sit around in Russian land? Are there any forts I'm paying for that I shouldn't be paying for? Nope, everything looks good here. Just my 300% inflation. My huge manpower deficit. That extra morale of navies. It's not going to be useful in the slightest, but whatever. But now, Welsh separatists, and where now? Glamorganshire. I don't actually know if I'm saying that right, but I think that's how you're supposed to say it, just based on what I know about that area. I think you're supposed to pronounce like Shire as sure. But I could be wrong about that. And yeah, you're already seeing why I don't want to annex any subjects. Because these guys are just going to spam so many spy actions against me. Say Saxony. Well, he doesn't like us that much. I should have been improving relations with him, but oh well. France is attacking Cusco. I'm not exactly sure what purpose that is supposed to serve. But you know what? It means he's not attacking me, so I don't care. Nassau. Do any of you fuckers have dead I could be taking on? No. Damn. That's a shame. At least Friesland can't join, because Friesland's big. Brabant's already in the coalition. And honestly, it's not that big of a coalition. Got like some HRE states in France. I'm pretty sure my allies can handle it. No! Damn it, Muscovy, why do you do this to me? Arg! Freaking advanced rebel strategy. Making me fight their rebels for them. Getting me even deeper in the manpower hole. Where is this? Oh yeah, over here. That's where I'm suffering attrition. I could just let him stay here, but no, why would I do that? After that, you can head back down, like, over here. Or so. We finally managed to reduce our overextension, and we have no possible missions. That's nice. Let's get this stated. And I don't even have enough to make London into a full core. I can make Essex into a full core, so sure. There could be some good power in the English Channel. I don't think it'll be enough to be worth collecting there, but we'll see. So what are these ships being built? 40 new lightships? I don't trust that tooltip at all. I really don't. What if say I wanted to privateer in the English Channel? There's people doing bad things there. You know, let's just try, say, protecting in the Baltic Sea. Let's see what that does. Look at our trade income at 75 right now. Alright, nice. We finally won that siege. Good. That's gonna go to the Ottomans. You can go, like, run back this way or so. Grab this guy. And you will not be getting yourself into any fights on the way, which is good. Because I don't want to be getting into any fights. In fact, I would just say go make a full retreat back to our land. Free trade income now. That sounds pretty good. Some more light ships. Probably a good idea to keep these guys protecting in the Baltic Sea. These guys can go join up with the main fleet. These transports. Where else can I make a stay? Wessex and Wales. This is Wales. And this is Wessex. Okay. That's a lot of stuff that I'm gonna have to full core. But let's also keep in mind that I'm gonna have to get like territorial core in these two provinces. That's going to cost 134. Aachen left the coalition against us. Why would you leave the coalition? I don't know. Guess he's just not interested anymore. Oh, I'm not complaining. See, the Welsh are not going to be very many. The particularists want to rise up down here. I remember this province. Have all the autonomy you want. I basically took this in case I wanted to go expand down here at some point, because I can go, like, attack Sakalava, and then jump over into the Malacca node. Or over to India, take on Vijayanagar. Put him in his place. The galley can go over here, the lightship can protect you. Still suffering attrition on this stack here. So you can head over to prop. And people are not as interested in coaching us these days. So honestly, I don't know why, because like, I'm super deep in the manpower hole. If they wanted to attack me, now would be a perfect time to attack me. But I guess they're just not interested. They're scared of me. That's what I'm gonna say. We're paying for forts we don't need to be paying for. We are. That one is not what I'm looking for. Here we go. Bohemia. Say they can occupy that by Hassa. Persia. Basically, I don't want to be paying for any forts that are not necessary. I don't know, I might not be able to get rebled for this from this war. Narvos grasslands. Actually, I don't think I will, because I believe that requires you to not separate peace anyone. So unless there is like over a million Russian casualties. Russia's only at like 740k. They don't actually have a lot of troops left. Ottomans are fighting Georgia. Is the Ottomans the attacker here? Georgia's the attacker. I'd actually prefer if the peasants like don't siege down this fort. So I will reluctantly attack Russia's peasants. Almost at a million casualties on our side. The Ottomans have been taking most of the brunt here. Over half of our casualties have been because of attrition. God. Yeah, that's the hard part about... Oh, okay, France is done coalitioning us. That's good. That's, like, the hard part about fighting Russia, is there's just so much attrition. I'm not an AI. I don't have limitless manpower reserves. Oops, accidentally hit the mic there. I mean, they're down to 100k troops or so. So you guys can head from Prague over to Lubeck. Anywhere with grasslands has good supply limit. Now we're getting call for pizza. Okay, so we're not going to be able to get wee blood for this in this war. It's going to have to be a bigger war for that. So let's see what these guys think of each other. Neutral and hostile. Very good. Russia wants Persian land now. That means they're not going to re-ally. Very good. So by calling Persia in against Georgia, they got Persia to be at war with Russia. Clever maneuvering. So this is 47 peace offer. So I could potentially take a bit of money as well, but it wouldn't be that much money, and I wouldn't get much of it. I just need to wait for 133 admins, like 2 more months probably. Loans are getting renewed, that's fine. Nizhny Novgorod, I know where that one is. That's over here. Persia. We're up to, what, 156 loans, and I can have 258? That's fine. Everything is fine. There's nothing to worry about. So, I mean, I could let them have fun with this some more, but This is all I want. Just those two provinces. And for you to annul all of your treaties with Spain. That also smooths out our borders a little. Screenshot that, just cause. We can go through exactly how all the casualties went down. Even Hossa contributed a little bit. Good job, Hossa. I'm proud of you. And now for Georgia. I don't exactly care what happens here, so you know what? Whatever the Ottomans want, they can have it. Everything goes to the Ottomans? Sounds good to me. Oh wait, that one's going to go to me? No. I don't want that to go to me. Even though I could make it a core, I don't want it to go to me. And yeah, Ottomans are gonna love me for this. I mean, I don't mind if Georgia exists. They can exist if they want to exist. If I take war reparations, he's still happy. Give up your claims in the Ottomans. Sure, that works for me. All of that land goes to the Ottomans. Georgia contributed a fair bit to that, but it's mostly Russia. So now Georgia's an OPM, but they're still guaranteed by Russia because they still exist. Repay our loans? Yeah, no. I like this mission. Oh, when you finally repay all your loans, you get interest per annum as a reward. How does that make sense? I just spent so much time paying back all my damn loans and now you give me interest per annum? Fucking hell. Remove Bremen from the map. You make a tempting proposition. But he's transferring trade power to me, so I can't. He'll probably cancel it as soon as the truce is up anyway. I was actually thinking of attacking Friesland for Friesland. Friesland's a nice province. Brunswick. And actually, I believe... okay, I was wrong. Würzburg will help you. Could have sworn you used to be rival to Würzburg, but I guess not. Würzburg hates Nuremberg, Frankfurt, and the Palatinate. Well, okay, fine. I could always fight Würzburg if I have to. It's not like he's got good allies, but... For right now, I kind of need to work on, like, not being so far in the manpower hole. I think also means I don't really need to be paying my troops at the moment. I'll let my manpower recover a little bit and then I'll start paying them again. None of these guys are taking attrition, so that's fine. Now Bremen is guaranteed by Brunswick. If I wanted to attack Brunswick, I could take these provinces, but that would be a ton of aggressive expansion. Still, as long as I can keep France out, it's not actually that big of a deal. Oh, right, I was supposed to be coring these provinces. Duh. Tuscany still likes me, because we've got, like, no aggressive expansion with him. Even though we're never going to be friends, we can improve relations. So how does the troop count look like these days? Well, Ming's doing alright, but I almost have the biggest army in the world. I actually did have the biggest army in the world at one point. But I don't anymore. It's very sad. Oh my god, the Commonwealth and Korea are now both attacking Russia. And Korea called in Ming. Yeah. That's just funny. So that was like 4,000 ducat loans. Eh, you know what, I think it's time to refinance. Repay a bunch of loans. Like another 100, 200k in debt. Repay more loans. Still some 3,400 loans. Go. All of our loans are 4,056. And we're down to 136 loans. So, that's why I like to refinance loans every so often, because I can have less loans, which means I can make more. Because that number of loans is as many loans as you can have. It doesn't actually matter how big the loans are. Anyway, from here it's mostly going to be fairly boring, so I think I'm actually going to end this video here. Thank you for watching, if anyone actually watches this, and I'll see you the next time I do a big war.